Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing a huge collective haul. So I started collecting this stuff when Lorac released their Pirates of the Caribbean palette. So it's been a little bit, maybe about three months. So I have them sorted out, not by store, but by product type. So I have palettes, I have eye stuff, and then face stuff, and then lip stuff. So yeah, let's get on to it. So I'm going to go ahead and do the normal disclaimer before we get into this. I bought all these products myself. None of them were sent to me. There's only two products that were given to me as a gift. And then there's Sephora freebies in here. But you know, other than that, I bought every single thing else by myself. And I will tell you which two were given to me as birthday and what the Sephora freebies were. I'm going to go ahead and start with the Violet Voss Pro Eyeshadow Palette. It is the Holy Grail palette. I honestly did not realize that they were still selling this palette. So, yes. Here we are. I love this palette so much. I thought it was limited edition, but then I went on their website and I saw it again and I'm like, oh my god, I have to have it. It's just so pretty. These colors, I can't even explain how gorgeous they are. It's a little messy. You do get some fallout and a lot of kick up with it, but it's so worth it. And the next palette is going to be the Disney's Pirates of the Caribbean Dead Man Tells No Tale by Lorac. And this palette is so cute. I love it. I love the Pirate of the Caribbean movie, so this makes me so happy. And it came with a free brush and a free eyeliner. And then on the side, there's a secret compartment. And I have the highlight and blush palette from them. So yes, it's a really pretty palette as well. I'm going to put that back in here. And I've used the eyeshadow palette and I've used the blush and highlight, and they're both beautiful. The pigment's really great and everything, so I like it a lot. These next two palettes I have are from Melt Cosmetics. It is the Rust Stack and the Dark Matter Stack. And these ones I actually got for my birthday from my boyfriend. I can't open it. So this first stack is the Rust Stack, and I actually have it on my eyes right now. I am using the shade Antique all over my lid, and then I put Rubbish and Rust all in my crease. If you haven't heard of the Melt Stacks, they're really cool. They're magnetic little circle pans, and there's a mirror at the top. Then there's all the different colors. There's Classic, there's Antique, Rubbish, Rust, and then Rot. So these are really pretty. I really like them a lot. There is kick up and fallout, but they're really pigmented. They're so easy to blend. They do have a pretty price tag, but I honestly think that they're worth it. So this is the Dark Matter Stack. This first color is Blur, which is a really good erasing color, transition, cleanup color. I mean, that color is perfect for everything. This next one is called Unseen. And then there's Enigma. And then there's Dark Matter. These are so incredibly pretty. I love them so much. And something that always makes me so happy is the magnet is so strong, the boxes stick together. The next palette is going to be this Becca palette. It's Aubrey Rogue Eye Palette. I love Becca's packaging. It's so sleek and pretty. So nice. Can't open it. This one is a little hard to open. I'm not even kidding. I struggle every time. So it is just some very neutral shades. They don't actually have names. Even on the back, it just says 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's not actual shades on here. But they're all nice. It's just nude and brown colors. And they are so creamy and so pigmented. I love them so much. So this is slowly becoming my favorite every single day palette. So the next palette is by The Balm. It's the Meet Matrimony palette. And I've wanted this one for a long time, but it's just so cute. And the back says Height 6'2", Eye Color Blue, Occupation Eyeshadow Palette, Enjoys Long Walks on the Beach, Creamy Eyeshadows, and Fabulous Liners. So cute. And so here are all the colors. So I haven't tried this palette out yet, so I will be doing a first impression with this palette. And then this next palette is by Pure, and it's the Soiree Diaries. And I got this one from Kohl's, actually. And I had heard nothing about this palette. I haven't seen anything about this palette. But I turned around after looking at the Balm stuff, and it was right behind it. So I was like, why not? Let's just swatch it. I'm not even kidding when I tell you these are so creamy and so pigmented. The metallic-y sparkly shades. Oh my god, I was speechless when I tried this in the store. And then also, let's talk about the packaging. Pretty rose gold all around it. And then the marble effect is so pretty. So here it is. I haven't used this one yet. I want to do a first impressions on this one as well. But the next two things are from e.l.f. They are brushes. This is a mini concealer brush, and then this is a contour brush that I use for my crease on my eyeshadow. And then this one, you can use concealer and you can use it to cut your crease or to just clean up your eyeshadow or around your lips. So this one has a lot of different uses. So I really like these a lot. They're really nice. And they are so incredibly soft. I'm not even kidding you. I love e.l.f. brushes so much. The next product is this e.l.f. Natural Lash Kit. And it's just some falsies. It is number 1713. I actually love this. I think they're $3 and they come with glue and a pair of lashes. Now their glue is kind of chunky. I don't wear falsies, so I figured why not try a cheap pair first. And they're really nice. I mean, they look natural on my eyes when I actually got them correct. These next two products are from Unique. I don't know about y'all, but every time I see Unique products on Facebook, I always wonder if they're actually good or not. So I saw somebody at the craft show and I decided to give them a shot and try them out. And I actually won one of these. I just remembered this. I won the really light pink one from a game on Facebook, and they sent it to me for free because I won the game. And this one, that one is in shade Hopeful. It's in shade Hopeful. So it's a really pretty light pink, but it tries to fall out. Like, it'll actually fall out of its container, which is a little annoying. But it's really nice. It's a little bit too light and subtle for me, but I use it for just a tiny natural light up on my lid. And then this one is my favorite. It is called Defiant, and it is gorgeous. Now, I will tell you, I am not an affiliate. I don't sell Unique. I just happened to run into a booth and decide to try it, and then run into a Facebook game and decide to try it when I won. And they are so creamy and so pigmented. Oh, I have to kind of smooth it out. So pretty. I can't. This color is just too gorgeous. I hope y'all can see it. So pretty. There we go. I'll put a little bit more just in case you can't see it. I really like them a lot. I think they're worth it. They are a little bit pricey, but they are good quality. The next thing is this MAC Pro Longwear Paint Pot. I got this a long time ago and decided to throw it in here. I actually haven't used it yet. I think I swatched it and tried to make sure it was my color. Yeah, but that's about it. And it's in Soft Okra, which apparently matches me perfect according to the lady. I plan to just use as a base for my lids because it erases the veins and everything, which, I mean, I'm sure you've seen in every single YouTube video in the entire world. So the next thing for eyes is going to be these two Stila Magnificent Liquid Eyeshadows. They are everywhere and they are so incredibly gorgeous. They are worth the hype and I love them so much. I tried the Smoldering Satin. I have not tried the Rose Gold Retro yet. I actually got this, the Becca Rogue Eye Palette, and then this next thing I'm going to show you to do a look together, because when I saw those three products on Sephora, I'm like, that would be gorgeous. And I got a look in my head, so I'll be doing a tutorial with these soon. So this one is in Smoldering Satin, and they are just so incredibly pigmented, and they are just breathtaking. So we'll go ahead and do a little swatch right here for y'all. So apparently when I was swatching this, my camera decided it didn't want to record it. So here is the Rose Gold Retro. And this next thing is the Milk Eyeshadow. And it is a liquid eyeshadow. So you only need a teeny tiny little drop of it because it is so incredibly pigmented. And this like is even too much, but it's so pretty. I hope you guys can see that well. Amongst everything else that is on my hand right now. That shade is in After Party. So again, by Milk Cosmetics. I love their packaging. This next thing is by Maybelline New York. It's Define Align. This has been my go-to eyeliner since high school. I love this stuff, and I separated it for a little while I was using the Marc Jacobs one, but then it broke, so then I just went back to this. Instead of buying $20 one, I bought a, I think, $7 one. And it works so nice. It's such a pretty black, and it's so smooth. It's perfect for waterlines. And this next thing I got is from The Balm. It's Bahama Mama Bronzer. And it says, bronzer for a sun-kissed look. And it's just your typical bronzer. I haven't used this one either yet. I actually used to never use bronzer, so I'm trying to get into that as well. I would just do my contour and that's it. And this next thing is, of course, the Champagne Pop Highlighter from Becca by Jaclyn Hill. It's in the prettiest rose gold packaging with the silver, and then on the actual product is a little champagne bottle with the little bubbles. How cute is that? I love this so much. So I don't know if this is like an anniversary edition or what, but I just saw it on Sephora, and I don't think I saw a regular version. I only saw this one. And then I got this as a freebie for my birthday from Sephora. It is a Tarte blush and then a Tarte lippy. The blush is in Party, and then the lippy is in a birthday suit. And for foundation, I got the IT Cosmetics CC Cream, and I am super excited to try this. I have not tried it yet, so I'll be doing a first impression on this as well. And I got it in the shade Light because I'm super tan over the summer. And then I got this Mario Badescu Skincare Facial Spray with aloe, herbs, and rose water. I haven't tried this one yet either. And another product from Unique is this Splash Lip Color. And it is in the shade Sentimental, which I have not tried yet either. So I have a lot of first impression videos coming up because I have a lot of products to test. And then I got this Anastasia Beverly Hills lipstick. It's a liquid lipstick in Dusty Rose. And then I got this as a freebie, and it's another Anastasia. It's their lip gloss, which I actually tried. It's in Vintage. Their lip glosses are amazing. They're so opaque and they're so comfy on the lips and they're not sticky. I like this a lot. And then the last stuff that I got is from Sephora, and it's all in this big bag. It's from when I went up to visit friends, and I went to a Sephora because we don't have one near where I live. So I got all this and two things I ordered, which I'll show you those two last because I'm so excited for those two. So I got this free little Sephora travel bag with the little lipstick, the passport, and the sunglasses for buying the smaller size products. And the first thing is this Kapari Coconut Melt. It's just coconut oil and a cute little packaging. The next thing is this Ultra Repair Cream Intense Hydration Skin Protectant Moisturizer. It's from First Aid Beauty. And I went in there, I told her I had super dry, dehydrated skin. So she recommended this First Aid Beauty item and then this Believe in True, the True Cream Moisturizing Balm. Clinically proven to retain moisture for up to 26 hours. So she told me to apply both onto my skin and that it will make it super moisturizing and my makeup will go on better, so fingers crossed. But I actually plan on doing a month-long video. It is going to take a while to film, but I will do updates every day on how my skin is feeling, if that truly is helping, and if it's feeling any more moisturizing, if I still have any dry spots. So we'll see. And I want to add the coconut oil in because I hear coconut oil is very good for your skin, and I actually got a big jar of it from Target for my hair to try and see if I can help moisturize my hair any too. And this next thing is this Too Faced Prime Set Refresh Hangover RX. It's a primer slash setting spray, and it's by Too Faced. And we all know from their actual primer, which I actually never was interested in trying their actual primer, but I saw this in Kathleen Light's video, and she sprayed it on, and then her foundation was so dewy and pretty, so I really wanted to give it a shot, and plus she said it was really sticky, which is good because you want your primer to be sticky so your foundation sticks to your face. And then I redeemed some points and got this Jose Maran set, and inside we have this body butter, this ultra lightweight moisturizing oil, and then we got the regular version of that moisturizing oil. That one's light and then that one's just regular. I don't know what the difference is. I'll have to look that up. And then whipped argan oil face butter. So we got body and face butter. And then we got this Surreal Skin Argan Finishing Balm. Yeah, it came in this cute little container. Then I got this Meat Corrector by Bobbi Brown. It's Peach Corrector and Bisque Corrector, just little samples. I got this when I ordered the two products I'll show you in a minute. And then at actual Sephora, she threw this in. It's a fresh lip sample of their Sugar Nude Lip stuff. So yeah, we'll just give that a shot. And then I got, from ordering the items, Urban Decay Meltdown Makeup Remover. I'm really excited to try this, so I cannot wait to give it a shot. It's actually a good size bottle. See, I'm very excited to try that. And the last two samples is this Fresh Lotus Youth Preserve Face Cream and this Hourglass Immaculate Liquid Powder Foundation. It's mattifying. I don't know why I got a mattifying sample when I have dry skin. I just threw it in the cart because it was offered and there were no other good samples. And these last two products, I was so incredibly excited for them to arrive. They are the Farsali oils. Now y'all are probably like, why did you spend all that money? But like I said, I want to do a skincare routine. I'm trying to fix up my skin, get it moisturized and dewy and glowy and pretty. So I'm starting to take my skincare very seriously. I did it before, which I really should have. You should always take care of your skin. So I've heard such great things about these, where they get rid of texture, they help moisturize, they even out your skin tone. So I figured it was worth the investment and I'd give it a shot. I'm really hoping they're going to be good. And like I said, I'm doing that month-long video for skincare, so I'm going to throw these in there as part of the skincare and see just how well they work. And I think this will be a good way for you all to see if it truly works as well. Which, I mean, like I said, there's been people that say it works, but we'll give it a shot and see if it works for me. So yeah, that is all of the stuff I bought. It is quite a big haul. Like I said, I will list everything below, tell you how much it was. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Make sure to comment below what your favorite product was and tell me what products you want to see in my first impression video. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and have a great day. Bye! Ow! Hurt my foot. Okay. It hurt so bad. Yes. This one is the Smoldering Satin. Then the last two samples are this face cream.